This ship isn't just advanced, it's built to be a ghost on the water. This is the Visby-class corvette and its mix of stealth, powerful weapons, and incredible agility in all its glory. Everything on board works together seamlessly, ready to strike first, dodge danger, or stay one step ahead of any enemy. It's so stealthy that by the time you notice it, it's already too late. The kind of ship that changes everything the moment it enters the battlefield. Oh, but what's that on the front of the ship? It's the standard Bofors 57mm 70-sack mkIII general-purpose gun, concealed inside a radar-deflecting cupola, ready to strike at a moment's notice. Tell me that wouldn't terrify you if you saw it transform and aim at you. They call it a regular gun, but I refuse to believe it. Just look at the size of these rounds. Are you telling me I shouldn't consider this a cannon, given the destruction it's capable of? Maybe they went with gun because this machine is fully automatic with 120 rounds of ready-to-fire ammunition, capable of firing up to 220 rounds a minute with a maximum range of 17,000 meters. That's almost 4 rounds per second. And while that's not machine gun fast, it's incredible for a 57mm cannon. And with that range, wow, this thing is perfect for handling both surface and aerial threats. Makes you wonder how these corvettes handle larger threats from a distance. Well, each corvette is equipped with 8 anti-ship missiles, 4 on each side of the ship, positioned under the bridge here and here. These RBS-15 Mk2 anti-ship missiles have homing capabilities with an active Ku-band radar and a range of about 200 kilometers, with a high subsonic speed of Mach 0.9 and a 200-kilogram warhead, these are formidable weapons. Just watch these practice targets getting obliterated. The missile bays are positioned below deck and fire through special side hatches to maintain the vessel's stealth. Think of it as a high-stakes game of peekaboo. Now, if you know a thing or two about ships, you're probably wondering about a significant issue, right? What about missile exhaust? Located on the port and starboard sides of the ship, or the left and right sides for our less nautically inclined folks, you can see that there are what look like 4 individual panels. Behind each of these panels is a missile. As I'm sure you're aware, firing a missile creates a ton of exhaust. This exhaust is filled with toxic gases and could fill confined spaces in seconds and seriously injure ship personnel. To prevent this, the design team created special canals inside the ship. When the crew fires the weapon, the poisonous fumes go into these special ducts and away from the ship. But even though the engineers were thinking of crew survivability on the Visby, these missiles have the opposite effect for those unlucky enough to be downrange of them. The Visby-class corvettes are currently retrofitted with the RBS-15 Gungnir missile system. This system employs the RBS-15 Mk4 anti-ship missiles that have marked improvements over the previous models. With an enhanced range of 300 kilometers and anti-jam technology, these missiles will not only hit farther, but also be more likely to get through enemy countermeasures. But enemies on land, sea, or air are not the only threats these corvettes need to watch for. They also have to deal with those pesky submarines trying to be sneaky under the water. While the cannons handle close-range enemies and the missiles take care of distant ones, what's the plan for submarines lurking underwater? Well, these corvettes come prepared, equipped with a suite of ASW 127mm rocket-propelled grenade launchers, depth chargers, and torpedoes. These corvettes can handle stealthy submarines up to 20 kilometers away. The main submarine anti-weapon? Torpedoes. Each corvette has 4 torpedo launchers at the rear of the ship. Talk about serious rear defense! Each 400mm torpedo tube can fire either Torped 45 or Torped 47 Saab lightweight torpedoes. This torpedo system was designed specifically for the Baltic Sea's environment with shallow waters and complex topography. In other words, it's like an underwater maze where finding anything is tricky, especially a hiding submarine. Thanks to this specialized system, the torpedoes can effectively clear the water and locate their target. With a range of around 20 kilometers and a depth capability of over 300 meters, these torpedoes can operate perfectly in the Baltic Sea, which has an average depth of 54 meters and a maximum depth of about 450 meters. These torpedoes can pretty much go anywhere in the Baltic Sea. Plus, with hydroacoustic homing, wire guidance, and an onboard computer, these torpedoes are fire and forget. Got a target? Fire a torpedo. What target? Well, what about defenses, I hear you ask? While these weapons can and are used for defense just as well as they are for offense, the Visby-class corvettes do have dedicated defenses, the most important one being the gap of anti-air capabilities. This gap has been noticed and now filled by the MBDA's Sea Ceptor Naval Air Defense System, which deploys common anti-air module missiles, or CAMs. You might be thinking, well, how good could these be if they're just common missiles? Well, these CAMs have a range of over 25 kilometers with high supersonic speeds. More specifically, Mach 3 speeds, which is 3 times faster than the anti-ship missiles on board. To put that in perspective for you, a commercial flight won't go faster than Mach 0.9. So these missiles, they go 3 times faster than the planes you see in the sky. To deal with any mines in the water waiting to trigger, these corvettes come equipped with Saab Bofors Underwater System Remote Operated Vehicles, or ROVs for short, for mine hunting, and the Atlas Electronic Seafox ROVs for mine disposal. Imagine that, using big Roombas to clean up any of those pesky Legos before they cripple your feet. Except in this case, they are giant explosives waiting for you to get close. These ROVs are a part of the Double Eagle Mark III multi-ammo soft kill mass decoy system. This very same system is responsible for defending against anti-ship missiles and guided projectiles by launching up to 32 omnispectral projectiles. For those wondering just what the heck omnispectral means, well, it's referring to the detection spectrums used by military technology, whether that be electronic signatures, infrared, radar, laser, or many others. These projectiles are just about as invisible as the ship is on radar. And did I mention these projectiles are time staggered and they are actually decoys? So let's say a missile is targeting the ship and this decoy system gets activated. Well, a burst of these little projectiles will get launched out at the missile that the missile's targeting system can't see. If it can't see them, it won't try to avoid them, and when it hits them, it'll detonate thinking that it hit the ship instead. Talk about hard to hit. And speaking of which, just how the hell does the crew manage all of these advanced technologies on board? Well, all this advanced technology would be difficult to operate manually. So each corvette comes with a state-of-the-art bridge and combat information center to help the crew coordinate their operations. Think of it as a central hub, like the dashboard of your car, but without the check engine light, of course. These corvettes are equipped with the CETRIS Command Control and Communication System, which includes the Saab System's 9LV Mark IIIe Combat Management System, the MAST Decision Support Aid, and an integrated communication system to coordinate weapons, systems, and the crew. Did they name it MAST on purpose because it's a ship? I bet they did, but I digress. The corvette also features a Saabtech Cirrus 200 radar and an optronic fire control system, fully integrated with the combat management system to help the crew find, track, and neutralize threats effectively. The radar setup includes a Hydra multi-sonar suite, which uses a passive towed sonar array, CTEC CBDS-26 Dual Frequency Active Variable Depth Sonar, or VDS, and a CTEC CHMS-90 hull-mounted sonar system for the ROVs as well. This ship is packed with radars and sonars front, back, and even on its drones, making it perfect for scouting and patrolling operations. And the sensors? Well, they include the Saab Microwave System's Sea Giraffe AMB 3D PESA surveillance radar. Now, you might be wondering why it's called the Sea Giraffe. It could be because it can monitor multiple threats up to 20 kilometers away or 65,000 feet in elevation at angles up to 70 degrees. Basically, it can look pretty far up into the sky to locate aircraft at a distance. But still, a giraffe? The thought of one poking its head above water to check things out is pretty funny. And to let them know if anyone is nearby, just a case of precaution if all else fails, a CS-3701 Tactical Radar Surveillance System, or TRSS, to provide electronic support measures and radar warning receiver functions. It detects if there's a hostile radar pinging out and about and gives the crew a heads up. So as soon as an enemy so much as looks at this ship, they'll know before the enemy does. All these different systems and weapons on board are definitely helpful for the Swedish Navy, but they would prefer to stay invisible against their enemies. Just how does this corvette manage to stay night invisible to their enemy? Just looking at this ship that inspires an old Imperial theme song, it doesn't look like it would be hard to see. Well, yeah, but we're actually talking more about technologically invisible, not really sight-based. Who uses their eyes anyways nowadays? With these large flat-angled surfaces, the corvette minimizes its optical, infrared, and above-water acoustic, hydroacoustic, magnetic, and pressure signatures, as well as their underwater electrical potential, radar cross-section, and actively emitted signals. And with its GHOST technology, which stands for Genuine Holistic Stealth, this ship basically reads like a water buoy to other ships. This ship has a detection range of 13 kilometers in stormy seas and 22 kilometers in calm ones without jamming up. The Visby-class corvette is detectable at 8 kilometers in rough and 11 kilometers in calm seas. Until you get closer, and all of a sudden, depth charges and torpedoes are coming at you from out of nowhere. These are some frightening water buoys. Yet stealth isn't enough by itself. The corvette's speed and agility are just as important to defend from or attack enemy units. But how can this corvette be fast and agile with all of this technology on board? Well, let's take a look. The size of the corvette is relatively small, clocking it at around 73 meters or 239 feet in length, and 10-ish meters or 34 feet in width, with a crew of up to 43 people. But that can't be it, right? It's not. I mean, even the structure alone is amazing for agility, since both the hull material and superstructure are an all-composite carbon fiber sandwich. In other words, it's a mixture of carbon fiber and vinyl laminate around a PVC core. This material is both strong, light, and has a low radar and magnetic signature, just adding to its quickness and stealth capabilities. Now, while corvettes range anywhere from 500 to 3,000 tons of displacement, or how much water is moved when they jump in, they are typically a jack-of-all-trades ship above to fill a variety of roles. To give you an indication of how light this ship really is, let's compare it with a similar-sized ship made of steel. Like the Gowind 1000-class corvette, that is just slightly larger in size, but has a displacement of about 1,000 tons, meant more as a patrol ship. Meanwhile, the Visby-class corvette clocks in at around 650 tons, a roughly 40% reduction in displacement, making this ship very light for its size, allowing its combined diesel and gas turbine arrangement to take full advantage. With four TF-50A gas turbines and two MTU-16V-2090 diesel motors, which run two Kamua water jet propulsors, this ship has a cruising speed of about 15 knots or 28 kilometers per hour and can go over 35 knots or 65 kilometers per hour for short bursts. Its lightweight carbon fiber hull and powerful turbines allow for incredible speed and agility, making it one of the fastest corvettes in the world, cementing this Visby-class corvette as a standout amongst naval ships worldwide. Bye for now.